I think my question follows on from Tracy's a little bit in the kind of commonalities between the different religions. And I suppose, you know, you mentioned something about feeling quite energized in this particular situation. And I'm curious myself as to maybe if you have a kind of a way of defining that a little bit.
You see, we are actually underestimating our essential nature or what we truly are. And somehow we are confined to the mind and body. Let me tell you, Descartes became world famous or philosopher because he said, I think, therefore I am. That means my mind is actually telling me who I am as an individual, not my body. Oh, no, no, I can't trust the body because it keeps changing, gets withered and kind of becomes wrinkly. I can't trust the body. So I'm something more than the body is what my mind is telling me. So his journey is, look, this is human beings are same. They are struggling with the human condition, trying to explore humanity. That's it. So he stopped at the mind, saying, I'm the mind. So when you think you are the body, you feel very limited. Look, I'm very limited. If I don't get food, I begin to suffer. If I don't get a glass of water, I'm in trouble. So as when you think of a physical body, you're very, if you like, limited in the level at which you relate to yourself. You increase, you go stage higher, say, I'm the mind. I've got the beautiful mind. So far, so good. Or you might go even higher and say, I'm the intellect. I've got tremendous sharp intellect. I can see through issues and analyze things. So you might stop at that level and you feel energized. Haven't you noticed? When like a jigsaw puzzle, things begin to fit, you get a thrill. So you get energized. That means you stop at the level of the intellect. But there's a fourth level. This is where the fun begins. When you actually experience yourself as the spirit, there is no power that you don't have. That is why when you see prophets and they say, they look at a person who's ill and say, look, get better. Their words carry the power and that man gets better. So now you become, once you become plugged into the system, spirit, you become energized, you get infinite power. I'm not exaggerating, infinite power. But you're very careful. You're not going to misuse it or show off or do magic miracles. If you can help somebody using, you know, you will lift people up. And this is, if you like, this is again, look at all the, that's why I say, look at the lives of the prophets. They're energized to such a level that they can bypass physical laws. They can literally do things because they are in that state where they have touched base with their true nature. That allows them this tremendous infinite is your, the power that you possess is infinite. You're talking about infinite heaven? You are that. It is here. And in fact, you see the story of Jesus. Heaven is here within you. You see the same ideas, different language, different vocabulary, but the same ideas. Again, I tell you, touch on one thing. This is what Jesus said. You see, I'm a Hindu, but I can talk like this without any difficulty. He said, look, if you cannot love the brother and sister you can see in front of your eyes, how will you love the father you can't see? What I was teaching is spiritual humanism. See, different language. If you cannot love the brother and sister, means people are visible, you can't love them, how are you going to love somebody who's sitting invisibly? Spiritual humanism. But you see, he didn't have that vocabulary. He was using this kind of his own vocabulary suited to his own time. So you see the unification. And I'm not exaggerating when I say you have tremendous power. You can really, you feel you can shift the world. You have, that's why they come as major powerful personalities who shift, if you like, the mindset of humanity. But they are not here for some conjuring tricks. Be careful. They will not do that. That means they've lost their way. Sometimes when you get spiritual experience, you get tremendous powers. You can read minds, you can shift objects, you do these things. But then once you start doing that, you become a little conjurer, little magician. You lost your plot. And this, if you digress and use your powers for these kind of personal benefits, you lost your plot and your powers will go. And they will create nothing but negative thing for your own, in your own life. There are people who touch base, who become spiritually enlightened, get tremendous powers, misuse them and fall down. There's a risk.